If in your family too you face opposition to eat moringa or drumstick leaves, make this chutney powder. The leaves are hidden in it. Hi, welcome to the Mad Scientist's Kitchen, reinventing the foodie in you. I'm Archana Poddar here. These are fresh moringa leaves that I've plucked from my neighbor's garden and I'm going to roast them into this. Let's check out the ingredients. Moringa leaves or drumstick leaves. You'll need urid dal, chana dal, sesame seeds, hing, coriander seeds, fenugreek seeds, red chili powder, optional ground nuts, some desiccated coconut, oil, and amchur powder, salt. I will add the list in the description box. This is what I'm aiming for. So for that, take a thick wok on low flame, add the washed and dried moringa leaves and stir fry. You just need to dry roast them. Let the heat take care of wilting the leaves. You can use sunlight to dry these leaves. You'll require 2 or 3 days to dry the leaves, or you can use your microwave also. You can see that the leaves are clumping together. The idea is to try and separate all those leaves. I'm going to try it with the spatula first. If it doesn't work, finally I'm going to use my fingers. This is the only step that takes a lot of time in this recipe. Otherwise, the whole thing comes together very quickly. Once the leaves are dried, you hardly need any time. I'm trying to peel off the leaves, get rid of any stalks if there are. This is the earlier batch that I had roasted. We are in monsoon season and it's very humid, so I'm making sure there is no moisture left. Our fresh and roasted leaves. Set aside and let's work on the rest of the ingredients. In a thick wok, add the chana dal on low flame, roast. This is what we are looking for. Remember to keep stirring continuously. Transfer to a plate, then roast your urid dal. Again, low flame. Continuous stirring from this to this. Transfer to the same plate as before and set aside. Roast the peanuts. Mine are roasted. However, since it is monsoon, I'm heating them up to remove all moisture. Once they are nice and crisp, transfer them to another plate to cool. Next, roast your coriander seeds from this to this. Transfer to the plate. Roast your sesame seeds. Again, they have to splutter, and your look is from this to this. Listen, you have to roast the fenugreek seeds. Here you have to be quick and careful, because if the seeds turn black, your chutney will turn bitter. Here is the comparison, beginning and after roasting. Except for the peanuts, all the roasted ingredients go to the same plate. Add hing or asafoetida, coconut, and the roasted moringa leaves to the pan. On the plate, add the chili powder and the amchur powder and set aside. Add a little oil to the moringa leaf and roast. I have peeled the peanuts, adding it to the pan. Add all the ingredients into the pan and mix well. Add the salt and let the mixture cool completely. Once the mixture cools down, add to the chutney pot and grind to a fine powder. So friend, have you subscribed to this channel? If you have not, please subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notifications every time I post a new video. The reason I like these dry chutney powders is I can use them in my stir fries or even in my dals. I use flaxseed chutney powder also to make this. Now store this chutney powder in an airtight container. I used this chutney powder when I was stir frying dal phara with my dosa and even with my aloo gobi. There are some other chutney powders that I do make on a regular basis. I will link them in the description box. So get your ingredients together and make your moringa leaf chutney powder. Like, share and comment on this recipe. Thanks for watching. See you soon with another recipe.